Hello and good morning to all. Welcome to this online session of OSA. Am I audible to you? Okay. So, dear student, we will continue today's online session. Yesterday, we have completed the article User's Perspective, where we have seen the building block primitives, as well as we have completed the online operating system services. Okay, so quickly we will overview so far what we have completed here. General overview, history of Unix operating system, system structure, user's perspective, and we are in the fourth article, operating system services, assumption about hardware, where yesterday we have seen the operating system services. Okay, so as I explained yesterday, there are various services of operating systems, right from file management, memory management, process management, device management, okay, then input-output management, scheduling, synchronization, security, inter-process communication, okay. All these are the functions or the services provided by the Unix operating system as well as every operating systems, okay. Kernel is actually the operating system. Kernel plays a very important role on behalf of user to execute the user's instructions or user's program. It's the responsibility of the kernel to execute the operations on behalf of user. So actually the kernel is the operating systems. Whatever the services provided by the systems, that is nothing but the services actually provided by the kernel. So what are such services provided by kernel? So you can see in this slide. Okay. So services like controlling the execution of the process by allowing their creation, termination, or suspension and communication. Okay. So it is straightforward. You can read the sentence. What is the meaning of this service? Controlling the execution of the process by allowing their creation, termination, or suspension and communication. Now, you know, process creation. Process creation, that means the creation of a new process that can be take place with the help of system called fork. Similarly, process termination. You can terminate the process in between. Now, how you can terminate the process? That is, there are system calls like exit system call is there, EXIT, exit. Exit system call means the termination. Okay. Kill system call is there, KILL, kill. Kill can terminate the process, abort the execution of the process in between. Okay. Then suspension. Suspension means you can stop the execution in between. That is again a kill system call. Communications, the one process can communicate with other process by means of various system calls. So that all things are done by the kernel. So that's why the first service, that is nothing but controlling the execution of the process by allowing their creation, termination, and suspension and communication. That can be taken care by kernel. Second, you can see the service there written, scheduling process fairly for execution of the CPU. So process share the CPU in time shared manner. That is a time sharing system. Yesterday I explained, processes are shared the CPU in time shared manner. The CPU execute a process, kernel suspend it when its time quantum elapses. Sometimes the time quantum is called as the time slice, which is a very short amount of time which is given for execution of the process, that is particularly in the nanoseconds. And the kernel schedules the other process to execute. The kernel later reschedule the suspended process. So that means scheduling the process fairly, smoothly for execution by the CPU. That is the job of, that is the services given by kernel. Clear? So apart from this, see what next? Allocating the main memory for executing the process. So primary memory, that is very important. Until and unless your program is not brought into the primary memory, the process cannot be executed. So who will do this? Kernel will do this, allocate the main memory for executing the process. ये कितना बड़ा काम है. It is a very important activity that played by kernel. ये मतलब जो कुछ आप execute कर रहे हैं, हमारा Google meeting चल रहा है अभी. Okay, we are communicating with the help of Google meeting. So this application is executing in the RAM, primary memory, main memory. So who is responsible for executing of this program? The kernel is allocating the memory for our Google Meet application, okay, which is currently executing. So that job is played by kernel, allocating the main memory for and executing the process. The Google Meet is the process which is currently executing. So that is the process, okay. So that job is done by the kernel. Then see, sometimes what happens, kernel allows the process to share a portion of their address space under certain conditions, but protect the private address space of the process from outside tampering. So sometimes what happens, the memory is not sufficient to execute the application. So that means your memory is short. Then what happens? Kernel frees some memory by writing the process temporarily on secondary memory. This is also a very important activity. Kernel kya karta hai ki jab aapki memory kam hoti hai. Kam matlab now 8 GB RAM, but you are installing the many more software. That's why it become low. Sometimes your program is not executing correctly. So kernel kya karta hai? Kernel will write some program temporarily on secondary storage device. That is called as swap device. And if the kernel writes entire process to swap device, the implementation of the Unix system is called as swapping system. And ye continuous hota rehta hai. Continuously the kernel is writing some process on the swap device, that is secondary storage devices, and bring the required pages or the program into the primary memory for execution. So this is a very important operations and the services which is given by the kernel or the operating systems. Not only the main memory allocation, but allocating the secondary memory for efficient storage and retrieval of the user data, that can take care by kernel. So this service constitute the file system. The kernel allocate the secondary storage for user files, reclaim the unused storage, structure the file system in well understood manner, and protect the user file from illegal access. So all this take care by kernel itself. That is, whatever is stored on the secondary storage devices, allocating the secondary storage device for file operation, storage operation, then accessing the user's data, all these things will take care by the kernel. Lastly, you can see there, allowing the process controlled access to peripheral devices such as a terminal, tape drives, disk drives, and network devices. So whatever the peripheral devices, okay, like you are connecting the pen drives, secondary storage devices, okay, printer, scanner, web camera, then many more things are there, external computer if you want to add or connect to your system. So all these system which is the peripheral devices connected to the operating systems, that will controlled by kernel, okay. So that is these are some of the services which are highlighted here, are nothing but the services provided by kernel. Definitely there will be a question in your examination, okay. Next, now see this, we are going to start today, that is assumption about hardware. What is the assumptions about hardware? So here we are going to learn the things related to the hardware. So actually it is divided into many things. The execution of the user process on Unix system is divided into two levels, okay. So what are these two levels? Means jab hum process execute karte hai, then it is divided into two levels. First one is the user level, second one is the kernel level. Ye aapko achhi tarah se yaad rakhna hai, dhyan mein rakhna hai ki whenever the user process is executed, it is divided into two levels. First level is user level, second level is kernel level. So when a process execute a system call, the execution mode of the process change from user mode to kernel mode. Now this sentence is very important. Whenever the process execute a system call, okay, whenever the process execute the system call, the process change its execution mode from user mode to kernel mode. Samajh mein aa raha hai aapko ki whenever the system call is encounter, आपने आपने प्रोग्राम लिखा और वहां पे सिस्टम कॉल लिखा आपने, तो दैट मीन्स अ फोर की सिस्टम कॉल फॉर एग्जाम्पल। तो एग्जीक्यूशन करते समय ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम को जब कभी भी सिस्टम कॉल एनकाउंटर होगा, देन द एग्जीक्यूशन मोड चेंज फ्रॉम यूजर मोड टू कर्नल मोड। तो शुरू में मैंने कहा क्या कहा था कि यूजर प्रोसेस इज एग्जीक्यूटेड इन टू लेवल्स। फर्स्ट लेवल इज यूजर लेवल, सेकंड लेवल इज कर्नल लेवल। बट वेन एवर द सिस्टम कॉल इज एनकाउंटर, देन द यूजर मोड इज स्विच टू कर्नल मोड, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज प्रोसेस चेंज फ्रॉम यूजर मोड टू कर्नल मोड। ओके, द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एग्जीक्यूट एंड अटेम्प्ट टू सर्विस द यूजर रिक्वेस्ट रिटर्निंग एन एरर कोड इफ इट फेल्स। तो इसका मतलब क्या है कि यूजर यूजर लेवल प्रोसेस विल नॉट एग्जीक्यूटेड इन टू कर्नल लेवल, बट कर्नल लेवल प्रोसेस कैन एग्जीक्यूटेड इन यूजर लेवल। इफ यूजर वॉन्ट्स टू एग्जीक्यूट सिस्टम कॉल्ड इन यूजर लेवल, देन इट विल गिव द एरर मैसेज, दिस इज नॉट डन बाय द यूजर लेवल। ओके, सिस्टम कॉल का एग्जीक्यूशन करने का काम सिर्फ कर्नल लेवल में होता है, वो यूजर लेवल में नहीं होता। सो दैट्स व्हाई इट गेट द एरर मैसेज। सो द पैराग्राफ यू कैन रीड हियर ऑन योर स्क्रीन, इट इज गिवन। द एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ द यूजर प्रोसेस इन द यूनिक्स सिस्टम इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू लेवल। फर्स्ट वन इज यूजर लेवल एंड सेकंड वन इज द कर्नल लेवल। व्हेन द प्रोसेस एग्जीक्यूट अ सिस्टम कॉल, इट्स एग्जीक्यूशन मोड चेंजेस फ्रॉम यूजर मोड टू कर्नल मोड। सो इवन इफ यूजर प्रोसेस डज नॉट मेक अ सिस्टम कॉल, द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम स्टिल डज बुक कीपिंग वर्क दैट रिलेट्स टू द यूजर प्रोसेस, हैंडलिंग द इंटरप्ट, शेड्यूलिंग द प्रोसेसेस, मैनेजिंग द मेमरी एंड सो ऑन। ओके, सो दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर ऑफ दिस यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, यूजर लेवल एंड कर्नल लेवल। नेक्स्ट सेंटेंस यू कैन रीड देयर, प्रोसेसेस इन द यूजर मोड कैन एक्सेस देयर ओन इंस्ट्रक्शन एंड डेटा, whereas processes in the kernel mode however can access the kernel and the user address space. So see here, this is a very important feature of Unix operating system. Jo process user mode mein execute ho rahi hai, they will only access the instructions and data of user mode only, but the process in the kernel mode however can access the kernel and the address space. So iska matlab kernel is having a weightage, kernel is having a power to access the user, to access the instruction and data in the user mode, but user is not having a power to access the instruction and data in the kernel mode. Okay, so that is a very important feature of this Unix operating system. Next line you can see there, some machine instructions are privileged and result in error when it is executed in user mode. Wahi maine kaha pehle aapko ki if user is trying to execute the machine instructions which are privileged. Okay, privilege means they are having access right permissions, and till the user is trying to execute that instruction, machine level instructions, then it will give the error. Okay, user is not allowing to execute the machine level instruction. Okay, user mode or user level is not allowed to execute the machine level instructions because they are privileged, they are having access right permissions, and if user is trying to execute the instruction of machine level, then it gives the error message. Last paragraph you can read here in the diagram, that is on the next slide there is a diagram. The operating system views from top or bottom, it sees which process are running. However, the hardware views if from left or right, it sees which mode is currently active. So I will change the slide so that you can see the figure clearly. So see here, my dear student, this is the figure where you can see what is the meaning of this figure. So first of all, you again read the last sentence in the diagram on the next slide. The operating system views from top or bottom. Okay, top or bottom, operating system can views from top or bottom. It sees which process are running, which process is running. Okay, and the hardware views if from left or right, it sees which mode is currently active. Now you can see, so from left to right there are two modes, kernel mode and the user mode. Okay, so process from bottom to top, so there are four process. A is the process, B is the process, C is the process, and D is the process. Suppose in your operating system, currently four processes are executing. Then you can see operating system can check that a process A is executing in kernel mode. Process B is executing in user mode. Process C is executing in user mode. And process D is executing in kernel mode. Okay. Whereas from the hardware point of view, you can see kernel mode, there are two processes, and user mode, there are two processes. So that is a multiple process and modes of execution that is shown in this figure. Okay. This is a very important part of Unix operating system, where you must understand what is a user mode and what is a kernel mode. Kernel mode can execute the instruction and data in the kernel mode as well as user mode. But user mode can only execute the instruction and data of user mode. It is not having access right to execute the machine level instruction and data of kernel mode. Ye baat sabko samajh mein aayi? Okay, those who are having problem for understanding, they can ask the questions or doubts, if any. Okay, so that we can move towards next article or next subtopics. Anybody is having problem, you can ask right now. Anybody is having problem, any doubt, questions? User mode, kernel mode. सबको समझ में आ रहा है क्या? User mode क्या है? Kernel mode क्या है? If you are facing any problem for understanding, you can ask the question right now. Okay? मतलब मैंने शुरू में कहा था कि आपको हमेशा आपके डाउट्स एंड क्वेश्चंस क्लियर करने हैं सेशन के दौरान. ओके, आफ्टर सेशन आल्सो यू कैन फॉर इंटरप्ट, व्हाट मैसेज इज देयर, फॉर इंटरप्ट कर्नल मोड इज यूज्ड. ओके, सियर, नाउ दैट इज एक्चुअली द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. प्रथमेश, सियर, द इंटरप्ट एंड द एक्सेप्शन. Okay, these are a special instruction or the special operations which are executed, and it requires a privilege. Okay, so you can write an instruction in your program related to the interrupts and the exceptions, but the execution will take place at the operating system level. See, actually, this is that topic, interrupt and exceptions. See, so a Unix system allows a device such as input-output peripheral or the system clock to interrupt the CPU asynchronously. So means there are different types of interrupts, like input-output peripherals or the system clocks. Okay, system clock is the one type of interrupt to the CPU which can interrupt the CPU asynchronously. इसका मतलब क्या है कि जो आपके कंप्यूटर में सिस्टम क्लॉक रहता है, that is also a generating a interrupt to CPU asynchronously. It is an event. Asynchronous means it is an event. After a particular time period, the system clock generate the alarm or it generate the signals that is given to the CPU. Okay. So on what happen on receipt of an interrupt, the kernel saves its current context. Kernel means operating system. Kernel saves its current context. A frozen image of what the processor was doing and determines the cause of interrupt and service the interrupt. Okay, so this process will take place whenever the interrupt occurred. Okay, so what the kernel is doing? Kernel saves the current context, that is a frozen image of what the processor is doing, and it determines the cause of the interrupt and service the interrupt. After receiving the interrupt, it restores its interrupted context and begin execution as if nothing had happened. Okay, so after servicing the interrupt, the kernel again restored the interrupted context and begin the execution. The hardware usually prioritizes device according to the order that interrupt should be handled. So there is a priority for handling the interrupt. When the kernel serves an interrupt, it blocks the out lower priority interrupts, but serves the higher priority interrupt first. Here, the highest priority interrupt will be serviced first. So this interrupt handling and interrupt servicing the interrupt is a common practice that will be handled or that will be taken care by the kernel itself, operating system itself. आप पूछेंगे सर ये कॉमन प्रैक्टिस कैसे है. तो कॉमन प्रैक्टिस मीन्स लाइक एवरी टाइम वी आर कनेक्टिंग द इनपुट आउटपुट डिवाइसेस टू आवर सिस्टम्स सच एज इनपुट आउटपुट पेरिफेरल्स. तो आप पेन ड्राइव अटैच करते हैं, आपने हेडफोन अटैच, आपने इंटरनेट का केबल अटैच किया, आपने वेब कैमरा अटैच किया, आपने प्रिंटर अटैच किया, स्कैनर अटैच किया. ओके, दैट मीन्स द इनपुट आउटपुट पेरिफेरल्स. तो आपने कुछ भी अटैच नहीं किया तब भी सिस्टम क्लॉक कंप्यूटर में जो ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम में जो सिस्टम कॉल है, ओके, टाइमर जो है आपके मदरबोर्ड पे, दैट कंटिन्यूअसली इंटरप्टिंग द सीपीयू असिंक्रोनसली. ओके, इट्स कंटिन्यूअसली सेंडिंग द इंटरप्ट. सो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग देन व्हेन द इंटरप्ट इज रिसीव्ड, देन व्हाट द कर्नल इज डूइंग, कर्नल सेव्स द करंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट. करंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट का मतलब क्या है कि जो भी करंट वर्क एग्जीक्यूट हो रहा है उसके जो डेटा रजिस्टर से सिस्टम रजिस्टर से उसमें जो वैल्यूज है उसमें जो एड्रेस है दैट करंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट विल बी सेव्ड. इन ब्रैकेट इज रिटन द फ्रोजन इमेज ऑफ व्हाट द प्रोसेसर वॉज डूइंग दैट एक्चुअली सेव्ड बाय द कर्नल एंड कर्नल डिटरमाइंस द कॉज ऑफ इंटरप्ट and service that interrupt accordingly. After servicing the interrupt, it restores the interrupted context such that nothing is happened. And actually the priority is given for execution of each and every interrupt. The highest priority interrupt will be executed first. So in the next figure you can see exception is also there, okay, as it is written here in this slide. What is the exception? An exception condition refers to unexpected event caused by the process such as addressing the illegal memory, executing the privilege instruction, dividing by zero, and so on. So exception is again a error which is generated by the system itself. So that is called as the exception. So I hope that in hardware subject in the first semester you might clear these things, interrupts and exceptions. So even though I will focus some points or focus some features of these exceptions and interrupt here also in our subject, but it is mostly the hardware related. Your microprocessor, computer organization. You had microprocessor in first semester, no? Microprocessor subject was there in first semester? No. COA was there. Okay, COA, that is computer organization and application. Okay, so the subject now change in autonomous. Okay, so no issue. See here, right now I will focus on exception. So what is the exception? Exception is a self generated error. So aap puchenge sir, a self generated error kya rehta hai? तो सी, सेल्फ जनरेटेड एरर का मतलब क्या है कि जो विद इन द सिस्टम द एरर इज ऑकर्ड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एक्सेप्शन. आप पूछेंगे सर थोड़ा सा और एक्सप्लेन कीजिए. तो सी हियर, अपोजिट टू द एक्सेप्शन देयर इज अ इंटरप्ट. इंटरप्ट इज ऑकर्ड फ्रॉम एक्सटर्नल. इट इज ऑकर्ड व्हेन अ एक्सटर्नल इवेंट टेक प्लेस. An exception occurred when it is internal event take place. Internal, any illegal operations or any error occurred, then the exception is generated. दिस इज द प्राइमरी डिफरेंस बिटवीन एक्सेप्शन एंड इंटरप्ट. तो आप यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ में दिखा दिया है, एन एक्सेप्शन कंडीशन रेफर्स टू द अनएक्सपेक्टेड इवेंट कॉज बाय द प्रोसेस विद इन द सिस्टम इफ द प्रोसेस इज एग्जीक्यूटिंग एनी अनएक्सपेक्टेड इवेंट. तो क्वेश्चन आएगा अभी कि व्हाट आर द अनएक्सपेक्टेड इवेंट. तो आपने यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं कि सच एज एड्रेसिंग द इलीगल मेमोरी, कि जो मेमोरी एड्रेस अवेलेबल नहीं है एंड यू आर ट्राई टू एग्जीक्यूट दैट मेमोरी एड्रेस, दैट मीन्स एड्रेस इन द इलीगल मेमोरी. सेकंड, एग्जीक्यूटिंग द प्रिविलेज इंस्ट्रक्शन, सो यू आर नॉट हैविंग एक्सेस राइट टू एग्जीक्यूट द सिस्टम कॉल बट स्टिल यू आर ट्राइंग टू एग्जीक्यूट द सिस्टम कॉल, दैट मीन्स एग्जीक्यूटिंग द प्रिविलेज इंस्ट्रक्शन, देन द एक्सेप्शन ऑकर्ड. Very common and simple, that is dividing by zero. So abhi aapko, you know that mathematically it is not possible to divide by zero, and still you are trying to execute the operation dividing by zero, then it is a error, that is called as exception. And there are such many more exceptions are there which are generated whenever the unexpected event are trying to execute by the process. So that is called as the exception. Okay, so now next line you can see the exceptions are distinct from interrupt which are caused by events that are external to the process. Okay, so jo maine kaha tha ki difference, interrupts are normally occurred external to the process and the exceptions are normally caused internally by the process. Okay, so next paragraph you can see exception happens in the middle of the execution of the instruction and system attempt to restart the instruction after handling the exception. Okay, see here, in between, in the middle of the execution of the instruction, the exception happens. Okay, and what happens after this? The system attempts to restart the instruction after handling the exceptions, whereas you can see interrupts are considered to happen between the execution of two instruction and the system continues with the next instruction after servicing the interrupt. So this is the exact difference between the interrupt and the exceptions. The Unix systems use one mechanism to handle the interrupts and exception conditions. So in both cases they are handling the exceptions and the interrupt, that is called as the they are actually providing some services to the interrupts and starting the instruction after handling the exceptions. Okay, clear these things to you? And this is actually the very important hardware feature of the Unix operating systems. Okay, so our topic name is assumption about hardware, and these things happens related to the hardwares. First one, we see the user mode, kernel mode, then we are discussing the interrupts and the exceptions. See, still there are something related to this interrupts and exceptions. So that is process execution levels are there, process execution levels. So what is this? The kernel sometimes want to prevent occurrence of interrupt when it is doing some important work. Okay, such as modifying the kernel data structure. Means what? A kernel sometimes want to prevent the occurrence of interrupts. कि कर्नल इज एग्जीक्यूटिंग सम डेटा स्ट्रक्चर, मॉडिफाइंग द कर्नल डेटा स्ट्रक्चर एंड सडनली द इंटरप्ट ऑकर, देन एट द टाइम द कर्नल वांट्स टू प्रिवेंट द ऑकरेंस ऑफ दैट इंटरप्ट. इट इज नॉट एक्सपेक्टिंग दैट इट शुड सर्विसिंग दैट इंटरप्ट्स, बट रादर इट वांट्स टू प्रिवेंट द ऑकरेंस ऑफ दैट इंटरप्ट व्हेन इट इज डूइंग द इंपॉर्टेंट वर्क. सो इफ सच सिचुएशन ऑकर्स देन व्हाट हैपेंस? In such situations, if the interrupts are not prevented, the kernel itself might get corrupt. So that is a very important sentence or a very, very important feature. The kernel is trying to prevent the interrupts, but still the interrupts are not prevented. Then it may happen that the kernel might get corrupt. Okay. So sometimes our operating system fails, our operating system corrupts, we are not able to proceed, we are not able to boot the system. This happens because of these operations. Okay, kernel is doing some important activity such as modifying the kernel data structure and external interrupt is occurring. तो कर्नल को इम्पोर्टेंट क्या है, कर्नल को इम्पोर्टेंट टास्क क्या है कि इट इज करंटली मॉडिफाइंग द कर्नल डेटा स्ट्रक्चर एंड सडनली द एक्सटर्नल इवेंट टेक प्लेस एंड वी आर ट्राइंग टू एग्जीक्यूट दैट, यू आर नॉट प्रिवेंटिंग दैट, देन द कर्नल मे गेट करप्ट. कंप्यूटर्स टिपिकली हैव द सेट ऑफ प्रिविलेज इंस्ट्रक्शन दैट सेट द प्रोसेसर एग्जीक्यूशन लेवल इन द प्रोसेसर स्टेटस वर्ल्ड. Setting the processor execution level to certain values mask off interrupts from level to lower level, allowing only higher level interrupts. Now that is what I am saying. The priorities are given to the interrupts. Preventing the interrupts means priority. Kya kaam pehle karna hai? What is important? So that will be executed first. That is called as highest priority interrupts will be served first. Then the lower priority interrupts. So in the figure next you can see, this is the important figure where you can see the typical interrupt level. What is this figure? This is the typical interrupt level. So there are interrupt, first of all you can see there are in this, all things are related with the interrupt as well as exception. So machine errors, clocks, disk, network devices, terminals, software interrupts. These all are nothing but the types of interrupts and exceptions, or it is the level of interrupts. Altogether, you can call it as a level of interrupts. So highest priority is given to whom? Highest priority is given to the machine errors. Machine errors, if it is occurred, then it will be served first. Second priority is given to the clock, then disk, then network devices, then terminals, and then lastly the software interrupts. So this, according to this priority, the kernel is servicing the interrupt. Okay, dear student, try to understand. According to this priority, the kernel is servicing the interrupt so that the kernel not get corrupted. Okay, so that is an important feature of this hardware assumption. Assumption about hardware, how the interrupts and the exceptions are occurred. So again, I repeat that. Priorities are given to the each and every interrupts. Highest priority interrupts are machine errors, clock, disk, then comes the network devices, then comes the terminals, and lower priority is to software interrupts. Okay, so clear with these things, interrupts and exceptions, because Prathamesh asked the interrupts kernel. For interrupts, kernel mode is used. Yes. Servicing the interrupt, kernel is doing that activity. Okay, kernel is doing that activity. It is in the kernel mode itself. Okay, and actually you are before you asked the question before start of this article, that is there actually in your syllabus, interrupts and exceptions. Okay, clear with your doubts, Prathamesh, or anything you want more clarification? Okay, any other? This year, these concepts are very important. This is the first article, first chapter we are in the first chapter. Okay, so try to clear your doubts itself. Any other question? No question. Okay, so now we can move to the next part, that is memory management. Okay, again it is related to the assumption about hardware. Memory management, see what is this. We know previously we have seen in the services provided by the operating systems, allocating the primary memory, allocating the secondary memory, swapping, demand paging, okay, paging, all these are the operations which take place in the operating systems. Kernel is responsible for doing these operations. So actually Kernel permanently resides in the main memory. So see the sentence number one. Kernel permanently resides in the main memory. So kernel ki jo jaga rehti hai, that is continuously in the main memory. तो एक क्वेश्चन मैं पूछना चाहता हूँ यहाँ पे कि हमने अभी तीन चार दिन से हम कर्नल 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 पढ़ रहे हैं. आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क वेदर कर्नल इज अ सॉफ्टवेयर और हार्डवेयर. व्हाट इज योर ओपिनियन? कर्नल इज अ सॉफ्टवेयर और हार्डवेयर. सिद्धांत इज सेइंग दैट इट इज अ सॉफ्टवेयर. इट इज अ सॉफ्टवेयर. सॉफ्टवेयर, वेरी गुड. सॉफ्टवेयर, यस, एब्सोल्युटली राइट. It is software, or rather I can use the correct word, it is a process. Kernel is a one process, my dear student. All the student kindly make a note and keep in your mind that kernel is the process. Okay, kernel is a process which is actually executing continuously right from the booting of the system. Okay, it is a process, or where it is located. So you can see the first sentence on the screen. The kernel is permanently located in the main memory. Ye jo kernel ka jo program hai, kernel jo process hai, ye continuously resides in the main memory. Iska location jo rehta hai, main memory mein rehta hai. So when compiling a program, compiler generate the set of address in the program that represent the address of variables and data structure of address of instructions such as function. Okay, compiler generate the address for virtual machine as if no other program will execute simultaneously on the physical machine. When the program is run on the machine, the kernel allocate the space in main memory for it, but the virtual address generated by the compiler need not be identical to the physical address that they occupy in the machine. Kernel coordinates with the machine hardware to set up the virtual to physical address translation that maps the compiler generated address to the physical machine address. Okay, this is again an important feature of Unix operating system. Yeah, aap jab program compile karte hai, then it will generate a set of address. Okay, so what that address contains, that contains the address of variables and the data structure of the addresses of the instructions such as function. आपने एक प्रोग्राम कंपाइल किया तो क्या होता है कि एक एड्रेस जनरेट होता है, and that address is nothing but the address of the variables and data structure. Okay, compiler generate the address for virtual machine. Actually compiler is a system software. It generate that address for virtual machine, okay, not for physical machine, but we require, we means the operating system requires the physical address, so that virtual address is translated into physical address. This internally happens by the operating system. Kernel is responsible for this memory management. Kernel is responsible for translating the virtual address to the physical address so that the correct execution will be take place. That is written there. Okay, so that is related to the hardware. That's why this point comes here in the memory management, in the assumptions of hardware. Clear with these things? Here in this paragraph, you just remember that what is happening after compiling the instructions. After compiling the instruction, the set of address in the program that represent the address of the variable and the data structure or the address of the instruction such as function will be generated. Compiler generate the address for virtual machine as if no other program will execute simultaneously on the physical machine. And actually the address translation from virtual to the physical take place internally. This is the job of hardware that can be take care by kernel itself. Okay, then the actual instructions will be executed. Clear with this thing? So that is the point related to the assumptions about hardware. So dear student, here your assumption about hardware, I again go back to the slide and see assumption about the hardware. This is completed. So ye pura jo chapter, pura jo article tha, assumption about hardware, isme aapne kya padha? There are user mode, kernel mode. Okay, these things are there, user mode and kernel mode. Kernel mode processes can execute the instructions and data of kernel mode as well as user mode instructions and data. But user mode instructions and data cannot access the kernel level instructions and data. ये चीज आपको याद रख. Kernel mode user mode में access कर सकता है. User mode kernel mode में access नहीं कर सकता. Interrupt and exception के बारे में हमने देखा कि interrupt क्या है. How kernel servicing the interrupt? What is exception? What happens when the exception takes place? Okay, and what is the difference between interrupt and exception? That also we have seen. Then the processor execution level. इसके बारे में आपने पढ़ा कि what is the highest priority interrupt? What is the lowest priority interrupt? Okay, that also we have seen with the help of this figure. And then lastly, we have seen the memory management. That is, what is the virtual address and why it is required to translate to the physical address. That is related to the assumption about hardware. Okay, any doubt up till this? So dear student, up till now we have completed. See, I will see the show you the contents of our unit number 1. Content means the first slide. Okay, content of the unit number 1. So what we have completed, see, we have completed the general overview, history of Unix system structure, users perspective, operating system services, assumption about hardware. This first 2, 3, 4 article are completed. Okay, 4 things are completed. This is very important introduction to the Unix operating system, unit number 1. And then what now we are going to see the next, again you can see the next article is basic concepts of OS. So you can ask the question, sir, basic concepts of OS ye wapas kyun aapne chalu kiya. See dear student, ye jo unit number 1 hai isme abhi aap jo remaining part hai, इस रिमेनिंग पार्ट में एक्चुअली लिनक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम के जो कमांड्स है, जो फीचर्स है, वो पढ़ने वाले. इसका पहला जो पार्ट था वो लिनक्स के लिए भी था, यूनिक्स के लिए भी था, और विंडोज ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम के लिए भी था. जनरली वो जनरल टॉपिक था, जनरल इंट्रोडक्शन टू द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, जनरल टॉपिक. बट तब भी मैंने वो जनरल था, लेकिन मैंने बहुत बार आपको यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम का एग्जाम्पल देकर वो पढ़ाया. दिस थिंग इज क्लियर टू एवरीबडी. Now see the basic concepts of operating systems. Like you can see the first paragraph, an operating system is a collection of software that manages the computer hardware resources and provides the common services for the computer program. The operating system is a vital component of the system software in the computer system. Okay, this tutorial means this chapter will take you through step by step approach while learning the operating system concepts. Okay, why to learn the operating system? This is also important. See, an operating system is an interface between computer user and the computer hardware. A operating system is a system software which performs all basic tasks like file management, memory management, process management, handling input and output, controlling the peripheral devices such as disk drives and the printers. Some popular operating system includes the Linux operating system, Windows operating system, VMS, OS by 400, AIX, Z by OS, etc. Mac OS is there, Android OS is there, iOS is there, various operating systems are there. Okay, so quickly means there is nothing to explain now, you know all these things. Following are some of the important functions of the operating systems: memory management, process management, device management, file management, security control over system performance, job accounting, error detecting aids, coordination between other software and user. Clear? Okay, I will not go in detail now. Okay, many more things we have discussed about this. And then what are the application of the operating system? Following are some of the important activities that operating system performs. That is the applications, or you can again say what are the uses or the applications of operating systems. So it performs the security by means of password and similar to other techniques. It prevents the unauthorized access to the program and data. Clear? That is called as security. Control over the system performance. recording the delays between request for service and response from the system, control over the system performance. That means it records the delay between the request for the service and response from the system. Job accounting, keeping the track of time and resources used by various job and users. Error detecting aids, production of dumps, traces, error message and other debugging and error detecting aids. Then coordination between other software and user, that means coordination and assignment of compilers, interrupt, assembler and other software to the various users of the system, computer system. So general, the security karta hai, control karta hai, job accounting karta hai, error detecting karta hai, coordination karta hai. All these things are nothing but the application of Unix operating system. Okay, now kernel. So we have seen various things about kernel, but still in this slide you can see what is mean by kernel and what is the exact you can call it as the meaning or the feature definition or something. What is operating system? An operating system is a collection of software that manage the computer hardware resources and acts as an interface between user and the hardware of the computer. It provides common services for the computer program. The operating system is a crucial component of the system software in the computer system. Okay, I just quickly, hurriedly, I am going to complete this part because in detail already we discussed in the first section. Okay, of this unit. What is the kernel? See, read it clearly. Kernel is a core part of the operating system and responsible for all major activities of this operating system. Kernel consists of various modules and it interacts directly with low level hardware. It also provides the required abstraction to hide the low level hardware details to the system or application program. An operating system is unable to run without kernel as it is an important program for working of the computer system. Okay, any doubt about this? Kernel is the important part of operating system and what it does, that also we have seen. Okay, next slide. The actual differences between kernel and operating system. From exam point of view, you can remember this thing. What is the exact difference between kernel and operating system? So what is the kernel? See, kernel is the core part of the operating system. An operating system is a collection of software that manages the computer hardware resources. Second difference, kernel acts as an interface between software and hardware of the computer system. An operating system, it acts as an interface between user and the hardware of the computer. Kernel, it plays an important role in memory management, task management, process management and disk management. Operating system, it's responsible for protection and security of the computer system. Kernel, there are two types of kernel, like monolithic kernel and micro kernel are the two types of kernel. Okay, later on I will explain. Once the physical education starts from 15th February, we are starting actual classes, where again I will explain what is monolithic kernel and what is micro kernel. So see, two types of kernels are there. First one is monolithic kernel and micro kernel are the two types of kernel. Whereas operating system, the single and the multi-programming batch system, distributed operating system, real-time operating systems are the types of operating systems. Okay, all these things are important in the point of view of examination. Examination mein aapko puchenge, what is the difference between kernel and operating system? Okay, then we move to the next, that is shell. Okay, this is the important points here we have to highlight. Okay, shell. What is the shell now? जैसे मैंने कहा था, मैंने quickly वो क्यों complete किया, because we want to move towards this shell. This is new to you. अभी kernel के बारे में आपने बहुत सारी चीजें पढ़ी है, operating system के बारे में आपने बहुत सारी चीजें पढ़ी है, kernel का definition, operating system का definition, उसके difference, ये सब चीजें हमने बहुत बार, मतलब हमारे पीछे के पिछले जो 7-8 lecture है उसमें हमने देखा है. So now the important part which is there on your screen, that is shell, S-H-E-L-L. This is a very important entity as far as the Unix operating system or the Linux operating system is concerned. Shell. So what is the sale and what is actually your perception about the sale? What do you think? What is the sale? Afternoon, we are having a practical session where again we are going to learn the various commands of Unix operating systems. Now you can see on the screen there is written a shell script is a computer program designed to be run by the Unix or Linux shell which could be one of the following. इसका मतलब क्या है कि shell is basically a program. Shell is basically a program, computer program which designed to be run by the Unix or the Linux shell which could be one of the following. So there are types of shell, ये जो bourne shell, C shell, corn shell, GNU bourne again shell, these are the types of shell. So इसके नाम आपको कुछ नए लग रहे होंगे but they are worldwide, they are very famous. Okay, those who are knowing the Unix and later on also you become a familiar or once you get familiar with the Unix operating system, the shell is these names are common to you. Bourne shell, C shell, corn shell, GNU bourne shell again. Okay, the shell is the command line interpreter. See the actual meaning of shell in the last sentence it is written. A shell is a command line interpreter and typical operation performed by the shell script include the file manipulation, program execution and printing the text. It is a command line interpreter. Shell is a command line interpreter का मतलब क्या है कि जो अपना command prompt रहता है वहाँ पे आपका program को execute करना, file manipulation करना, कुछ आपको changes करने हैं, program execute करना है, printing करना है, that all things you can do on the command prompt itself. That's why shell is a command line interpreter. Okay. ये जो फर्स्ट शेल इज अ कमांड लाइन इंटरप्रेटर एंड टिपिकली टिपिकल ऑपरेशन परफॉर्म बाय द शेल स्क्रिप्ट इंक्लूड द फाइल मैनिपुलेशन प्रोग्राम एग्जीक्यूशन एंड प्रिंटिंग टेक्स्ट एक्सेट्रा दिस इज अगेन कॉमन एंड अ वर्ल्ड वाइड एप्लीकेशन व्हिच कैन बी डन बाय शेल इटसेल्फ. सो थ्री थिंग्स आर देयर इन दिस स्लाइड. फर्स्ट वन, व्हाट इज मीन बाय शेल स्क्रिप्ट. Shell script is the shell program or computer program which is executed by Linux. There are types of shell: bourne shell, C shell, corn shell, GNU bourne shell again. And what is the shell? Shell is a command line interpreter which is used to execute the file manipulation, program execution, and printing the text. Okay, this thing we have seen. So I will stop here because this is a tomorrow on this topic we will see what is mean by again what are the features of shell. Okay, so how to write a shell script, here it is written. Okay, that we will see how to write a shell script, how to run the shell script. Okay, what is shell prompt, then again these are the bourne shell has the following sub categories. Shell script kya hai, basic concepts of Linux ke bare mein padhenge. Okay, kernel and user mode that we have seen. Okay, and the basic Linux command, advanced Linux command. Okay, and actually the installation of the Linux interactive that I will explain. So tomorrow we will see all these things. Okay, probably now we are towards the end of this unit number one. Okay, not today, not tomorrow, but our two lecture hame lagenge for completion of this unit number 1. Okay, introduction to the operating system. Okay, fine. So here I will stop. You go to the LMS and mark your attendance there. So those who will face the problem for marking the attendance, they can mark in the Google Sheet also, which is shared on your WhatsApp group. So good day. I will end the meeting. Thank you very much for joining. Mark your attendance.